And Durban, I was born in Durban on the Bluff, which is an island in itself in Durban, or well, so we thought it is, but it's still joined by mainland. but we are the busiest port in Africa, somewhere in excess of 5,000 ships a day calling, just for starters, and it is one of the top five conference venues in the world, as it's been, has an accolade to that. So it is well worthwhile coming to visit us. It has also got to be one of the most colourful countries or towns that you could ever visit. We must have 15, 20 different cultures happening at the same time in Durban. Let's have a look.
Okay, something I forgot to mention about the hotel.
As much beautiful beach as what Rio de Janeiro has got, if not more. Our beach carries on for 10, 15 kilometers before the first outcrop of rocks. The kind of waves that we do experience on the coast, this is an exceptional storm that we had, but it could happen. It happened in July, it could happen in August, it just depends. That wave was in excess of 5 meters. This is Otago Rocks, which is our neighboring village, and the type of photograph you can get from there is absolutely stunning. Food abundance. You can go anywhere in Durban and you will eat a different cuisine. We have everything from Chinese food through to... I don't know if we've got a Korean restaurant, I must say, but we have a large Indian influence in terms of where we are. And we have a specially designed meal that only this Durban Indian person knows about. And this is that meal there. It is called a bunny chow. And for all those tourists, there are no rabbits involved in a bunny chow. It is half a loaf of bread, filled up with curry and rice, be it lamb curry, be it mutton curry, be it beef. And you eat it with your hands. And the trick is you eat it and you don't get dirty. You don't even need a serviette to clean up with afterwards if you know how to eat one properly. Valley of a Thousand Hills is just outside of Durban and I'm sure we will go and visit it. There's a large cultural center there that has been set up specifically to show us the Zulu person's traditional clothing, traditional wear, Zulu dancing, and that sort of thing. The Durban Rickshaw on the Durban beachfront is an extremely colourful person. There are about 8 or 10 of them still in existence. They date back to the very early days of Durban, when there was very little transport systems in place, and this was the means of transport in Durban. You would sit on the back and be taken around. Your Zulu dancers, this opportunity lets you get up close to them and get them moving in action. And as you can see, their attire is extremely interesting, something that's pretty unique to Durban. Okay, once again we look at our beaches. We have a promenade that stretches for 8 kilometers or something of that sort of totally walkable, beautiful area to access, and the beach temperature or the water temperature in Durban never drops below 21 degrees centigrade, and invariably it will go up to about 25 or 26 in the middle of summer. It is a warm environment, it is wonderful. Sporting facilities, i.e. surfing is big in Durban, it's one of the surfing capitals of the world, and we have piers that allow you to get up close to surfers, so you don't have to have long lenses to get superb action shots. We have a skateboard stroke biking park right opposite the hotel, easy of access, walk out in the morning and you can get images of people doing all sorts of things. We have a theme park in Durban that is called Ushaka, meaning the shark. And it is built around a made-up wreck. It's not a genuine wreck, but the ship that you see in the middle that looks like a wreck is actually the aquarium. Around it you will see the ponds, and you go inside the wreck, and it is the underworld that we experience. Fish and the Ark, and very easy to see what happens under the ocean. Anyone who's brave enough, they allow you to get into that tent. Not yet. Okay, we've got one at the back. Wonderful. We have a wonderful yacht mall, which is beautiful, beautiful for photographic purposes of evening, nighttime. And of course, we have, being on the East Coast, the morning sunrise is paramount. We have numerous piers hanging into the ocean, and many of them have been designed specifically what we as photographers believe is for our purposes. This one has a restaurant on the end of it. No, sorry, not this one. This one is a whalebone pier, and it's put there just, it's actually a stormwater drain that has a stormwater outlet. But on top of it, you have a pier of beautiful proportions to go and photograph the sunrise from. Or even during the day, same pier. We have an international acclaimed and awarded stadium in Durban. It was built to host the World Cup in 2010. We were one of the host cities. And the stadium provides a railway system that goes to the top of the arch, and you can see all of Durban from on top, and you can get beautiful views and beautiful images. It's been designed by, I'm sure, a photographer, because the amount of photographic opportunity at that stadium abounds. We have, as part of the many cultures, we have a mosque in the middle of Durban that is beautiful. It's one of the largest in Africa, and you have free access to photography inside the mosque at most times of the day. Of course, we have some old buildings, but by European standards, they are young buildings. We only go back 300 years or something of that sort. As I start, the Durban City Hall is absolutely magnificent, the way it's been built, and it is lovely for day or night photography. Of course, we have K5. Everybody, number one, wants to come and see South Africa and go on safari. That is our intent, that we will have a day safari in the middle of the Congress, and hopefully, we can see the Big Five. Bear in mind, they are wild animals, and we have no control over their whereabouts. We're not going to a zoo or to a theme park, we're going into the bush. Thank you.
Summer when it's very dry in that area, but in August all the fields have been planted, either green or the yellow.